Now, I'm here to present my idea on criteria A, which is totally on focus and method of the World Studies Extended Essay. Now, criteria A focuses on few important parameters, one of which is the topic that you have chosen, the student have chosen for the investigation. Second would be the research question itself. We'll talk about each of the topics in detail. And third is about the methodology of your implementation. Okay, so when it comes to interpreting the assessment criteria, my criteria A is basically based on research question. So in World Studies Extended Essay, your research question must be quite focused and should have a global relevance that a student have investigated at his own time. And definitely it should be an interdisciplinary essay. So there is the introduction of extended essay, World Studies Extended Essay is larger in words as compared to general extended essay. So when it comes to physics or any other subjects, your introduction should be precise. But when it comes to World Studies Extended Essay, your introduction could be bigger because you are going to explain your idea of research question with respect to two subjects. So to get the higher band in criteria A, your topic must be communicated accurately and effectively. Research question should be clearly stated and focused, and methodology of the research should be complete. Now, verbally we know these are the criteria, but how to fulfill this particular things while a student is doing his essay? Scoring a higher band, when you're choosing a topic, students should clearly identify the topic that he or she has chosen, and it should be well explained. Students should provide sufficient evidence to develop arguments relevant to RQ. It should not be just like, I have just written an RQ and there is one evidence that I have. You should have more than one evidence that supports your RQ. Choice of subject should be justified. And the focus of essay should not be lost at any particular point. So if at all I have to fulfill criteria of 4,000 words, or say maximum limit is 4,000 words, the student has this mentality that I can't, what happens if I don't go beyond 3,000 words? It's not a problem, but whatever essay you write should be quite focused. Then research question should be clearly stated and it should be posed as a question. Identification and explanation of research questions should be communicated effectively, because if I don't understand your RQ and if I feel that there is no justification or there is no use, like just for sake of doing World Studies, you have chosen two subjects while it could have been easily done through physics, then it's not the purpose of the World Studies Extended Essay is not met. So focus of the research should be clear and very well appropriate. Now, you choose one global theme and make it focus for 4,000 words and choose an appropriate method. Like it could be data analysis, it could be hands-on experiment, it could be a simulation based, it could be a combination of both. Then there is a personal question answer section into this. Selection of source is very, very, very important. You can't just go to any general website and pick up the source. It has to be an authentic website like .edu, .gov or something like that. And you should have subject skills of one of the subjects. So if I am doing physics and bio together, one of the subjects should be my subject that I am pursuing at my DP level. So there are many stumbling blocks that also we can discover or discuss. So focus, when I talk about the focus of World Studies Extended Essay, you choose two subjects, one of which you must be studying. And the process of research and writing the World Studies develops the international mindedness. So you should not restrict yourself while you are discussing issues. See, local manifestation is fine, but when you are discussing a global issue, try to extend your feathers and go from this small, narrow community to a global community. Try to relate this to global have a global consciousness basically. Now, these are the six global themes. You choose one of the global themes first. So unlike other extended essays wherein you choose your subject first and then extend your feathers to find out the topic, here it's the other way around. It's always recommended that you choose your global theme first, the theme that you are interested into, then try to find out a topic of interest that you would like that fits into this particular theme, and then choose your subjects. So if I'm good at physics and maths, I should not restrict myself. No, I'm going to choose a theme. So you're doing it other way around. Now, this is the proposed sequence that you should take while doing your World Studies experiment essay. Choose a global theme, find a topic. Now try to find the disciplinary lenses, like I choose my two subjects. Then I try to frame my research question. So it requires lots and lots of brainstorming. People say, oh, research question is just simple. You pose it as a question. But in World Studies, you have to, your research question should tell me that interdisciplinary lens is needed in this particular part. And last should be sources of data collection. How are you going to collect your data? So if you have this particular mind map made for yourself, so in your RRS document, research reflection space, if you have your document arranged in this way, it will always help you. Do your research in such a way that there are some kind of integration takes place. There could be a cartoon. Somebody might have drawn a cartoon. Somebody might have drawn a sketch which depicts everything that you want, your that completely fits your research question, then definitely yes, artistic synthesis works for that particular part. So always keep this thing very much clear. Now, students, your primary sources could be works of art. Supervisors should emphasize on this thing. The primary sources could be any form of art, any film, any music, any interviews, self-generated survey data, and reports of experiment, and whatever newspaper articles I particularly find out. So there is no restriction on hands-on experiment. Even if I'm choosing two subjects of sciences, your primary resources could be anything. The only most important required criteria is critical analysis. Now, sometimes you also incorporate your primary source along with the secondary source. This is a perfect fit for your World Studies experiment essay. Have some primary data, but also take a secondary data, and it fits everything into the picture. The secondary sources could be any academic contextual text or any academic evaluation, any journals or media sources. Now, when it comes to media sources, you know how to select your sources. Now, I can't just rely on anyone's speech. I'll have to see whether it is based on some authentic evidences or not. So always try to provide sufficient evidence to support your arguments. I would like to talk about a few important points. So the significance and importance of global issue must be established in the introduction itself, first point. Second, the research question should connect the global issue to the local manifestation. So explain your research question, identify the lenses, like the subjects that you want to study, determine or find out the appropriate key concepts that you are going to use, explain why research question is going to require an interdisciplinary approach, and indicate benefits of integrating approach that you can see on your screen, highlight the material, sources, data, and evidences from two subjects that you will be using with some explanation of why they have been chosen.